Hi, let us see in this session some of the working examples on initial value and final value theorem. So let us see this question. Verify the initial value theorem for the following functions. So first let us write the initial value theorem. Initial value theorem. So that is, if x of t's function Laplace transform is say x of s, so then what is the initial value? X of 0 is called as the initial value, which is equivalent to limit s tends to infinity s into x of s in Laplace transform domain. Remember that x of 0 is called as initial value of x of t. So use this formula to find out the initial value. So let us see the first question. So what is the first question given? X of t is equal to 4 minus 2 into e power 3t. First find out the initial value just by substituting t is equal to 0 in this given equation. Just substitute t is equal to 0. So that is the initial value. So therefore what is the initial value? The initial value is x of 0. So that is equal to 4 minus 2 into 3 into 0. That means 0, e power 0, e power 0 is 1, 4 minus 2, the answer is 2. So this is the initial value, that is equal to 2 in time domain. So next, find out the Laplace transform of this given x of t. So the Laplace transform of given x of t is x of s, so that is equal to Laplace transform of 4. That means Laplace transform of 4 is 4 by s minus 2 into Laplace of e power 3t is 1 by s minus 3. So this is the Laplace transform given x of t. So let us simplify this. 4s minus 12 minus 2s by s into s minus 3. So which is 2s minus 12 by s into s minus 3. S into s minus 3. So let us use the formula. So therefore x of 0 is equal to, in Laplace domain what is the corresponding formula? Limit s tends to infinity s into x of s. So just substitute limit s tends to infinity s into what is given x of s. The given x of s is 2s minus 12 by s into s minus 3. So cancel out s and s. You should not substitute infinity directly here. Just divide the numerator and denominator by s, or take s as common in the numerator and denominator. So therefore it will come out as limit s tends to infinity. If you take s as common in the numerator and denominator, the numerator will become 2 minus 12 by s. The denominator will become 1 minus 3 by s. If you substitute s is equal to infinity, this term is 0, this term is 0, the answer is 2. So therefore, in this way you can verify the initial value theorem. In the time domain, the answer is 2. Similarly, in the Laplace domain, the answer for initial value is also 2. So that means the initial value theorem is verified. So therefore, let us see the next example. Another example. What is the given question? B, x of t is equal to 3 into e power minus 5. So what is the initial value? X of 0. That means substitute t is equal to 0 here. E power 0 is 1. So that is x of 0 in the time domain. So this is the initial value of x of t. So let us check it out whether the same answer will come in Laplace transform domain or not. So what is x of s? X of s is equal to 3 by s plus 5. So what is the initial value corresponding formula in Laplace transform? X of 0 is equal to limit s tends to infinity s into x of s. So just to substitute x of s, that is limit s tends to infinity s into what is x of s? 3 by s plus 5. So divide numerator and denominator by s. So that means it will become limit s tends to infinity 3 by 1 plus 5 by s. If you substitute s is equal to infinity, 5 by infinity is 0. 1 plus 0 is 1, so the answer is 3. So therefore, you can see that the initial value in time domain is 3 and the corresponding initial value in Laplace transform domain is also 3. That means initial value theorem is verified. So now let us see the next question. Determine the initial value x of 0 or x of 0 plus, it doesn't matter. So determine the initial value x of 0 plus for the following Laplace transform. Let us see the first question. What is given? X of s, that is equal to 4 by s square plus 3s minus 5. So what is the initial value? The initial value, so that is x of 0, so that is equal to limit s tends to infinity s into x of s. Just to substitute x of s, so that means limit s tends to infinity. So s into x of s is 4s by s square plus 3s minus 5. So divide the numerator and the denominator by s square. So therefore the numerator will become 4 by s. The denominator will become 1 plus 3 by s minus 5 by s square. If you substitute s is equal to infinity, this term is 0, this term is 0. So the numerator is 0. So 0 by 1 is 0. So this is the answer for this problem, initial value. So let us see the next example, B. So what is given x of s? Given x of s is 3s plus 2 by s into s square plus 3s plus 2. So what is the initial value? The initial value formula, just write the initial value formula. Initial value x of 0 in time domain is equivalent to limit s tends to infinity s into x of s in Laplace transform domain. So just to substitute, given x of s, limit s tends to infinity s into what is given x of s? 3s plus 2 by s into s square plus 3s plus 2. So just cancel out s and s. So divide the numerator and denominator by s square. So that is limit s tends to infinity 3 by s plus 2 by s square, 2 by s square plus 1 plus 3 by s plus 2 by s square. If you substitute s is equal to infinity, this term is 0, this term is 0, this term is 0, this term is 0. So 0 by 1 is 0. So therefore the initial value for this problem is also 0. So this is about some of the working examples on initial value theorem. Thank you.